In any system where you need compliance or where there are multiple administrators and you want to know what happened, what everybody changed, reconfigured or deleted, you need some kind of audit log. And in Orchard, not yet in the RC2 version that I'm using here right now, but still in Orchard there is a feature that will be part of an upcoming version called Audit Trail. And well, Audit Trail is a full-fledged audit log. It records all kinds of events, all kinds of changes that happen in the system. It records content changes, configuration changes. It can log in, it can log logins and failed logins, as well as any other custom events that you might implement, since just as everything, Audit Trail is also extensible. So, let's see how it works. Well, first of all, we'll need to enable it, of course. So the module and the feature is called Audit Trail. And once we have it, we will get this menu item here on the admin called Audit Trail. Well, there is nothing yet here because we didn't do anything in the system since turning on Audit Trail. So let's actually do that. And before we go into that, let's see what kind of settings we can change here. Well, first of all, you can select which events to record. These are the built-in ones, or rather the ones that are already out of the box and not necessarily built into the Audit Trail module itself, but in other modules that extend it. But here we have a lot of content related events, as you can see. Pretty much anything happens with an event, you will be able to track it, including removal. So again, keep in mind that deletes in Orchard are soft deletes, so we'll be able to restore everything even if a content item is deleted. User events are available here as well. So as you can see, if somebody signed up or logged in or a login failed or anything like that. And these are only the built-in events. You can create your own from your own module too. There are other configuration options too. You can log the IP address of the current clients. And by the way, this will also work if there is a reverse proxy in front of the application. Still, the correct IP of the client will be logged. And you can also exclude content types from being recorded. Or content events will be only recorded for content types that are not excluded here. Well, let's leave everything on the default here. And finally, there is also trimming. Audit Trail can generate a lot of data, and the Audit Trail log can be very large. So the idea here is that there can be a retention period that you say that, okay, I don't want anything from anything that is older than 10 days or 30 days or something. If something happened, if there was an incident, I noticed it before that. Again, it depends on your use case, which what is good here. Maybe for compliance reasons you have to keep everything. Maybe you have to keep everything for 5 years, but it's up to you to configure here. Oh, we won't really need it here, so let's disable trimming altogether. All right, and now let's actually check out whether there's anything in Audit Trail. Not yet. Let's change something in a content item. And again, let's go back to our trusty blog post here under blog. Let's see what happens if we change something here. And in the meanwhile, we also learn a bit more about Orchard's versioning. So let me remove this unnecessary suffix there. Let's add some paragraph here we will see the changes. And let me publish this contents item. Now we are done. Let's go back to the audit trail. And now we have two events here. Let's take a look and let's try to understand everything what's happening here. Well, first of all, we have a saved event, a content item saved event, and a content item published event. Why is that? We just published. What happened in the background is that when you publish a content item, first it is saved as a draft, and then the draft is published. So we already modified that content item a lot of times, hence why the version that was published is version 6. So all the previous versions are also available in the system, and with Audit Trail you can also access them. So let me do another change. So you see that there are multiple versions too. And let's remove this paragraph and publish again. Let's go back to Audit Trail, and you see now we are on version 7. And actually, you can also see what was precisely changed. If you go to details here on the saved event, we just get an overview of what happened here. Every audit trail event has some basic data, like the name of the event or a category, timestamp, username, etc. And of course the IP address as well, which we configured that it should be saved. The corresponding content item is linked from here as well, as well as the version itself. So if we open the version, we see that, well, it is here. The suffix in from the title was removed, and we have some paragraph here. And if you open the published event, we get a bit more too. We also get which fields were actually changed here. We should be able to see something similar for the saved event as well. Yes, for the next one, once Audit Trail was actually enabled well prior this version was created. And as you can see, we can see what changed. And we can also see it here in its full glory. Well, that paragraph was removed. So yeah, not much to look at here. In the event log, you are also able to filter in various ways. As you can see, you can filter on the daytime when that event was logged. Since there are multiple categories, you can also filter on categories. Well, we just have a couple of content item events, so not much interesting here. And you can also filter on the name of the user who did these actions. And some sorting is also available. So it's not just that you can check out what changed, but as you can see, you can also restore previous versions. So if you want to go back to this previous version, now it should be there. Yeah, and as you can see, the suffix is missing, but the paragraph is here, so that was the first change we made. And we can also restore deleted content items. So let me quickly create a page just so we can then delete it, and we'll be able to see how that removal is logged and how we can restore it from the set of deleted items. So, let's call it removal demo. Yeah, and let's publish it. And as we expect, we get an event corresponding to it with version 1. All right, but now let's open up the content items page, content items list, and let's remove it here. Okay. And here we also get an event for this removal, but again, we can restore it. So just clicking here, we can get our content item back. Well, it's a draft, you now get an option to do whatever you want with it. And this was just the basic audit trail log and everything, but there is also an audit trail part. So let's go to page and let's check out what it does. Here, again, back to the content type editor, and let's go to parts and let's add audit trail part. Yeah, as you can see, it is here. And well, as the hint also says, this will allow you to add the comments to the event that is created when you change something on the content item. So, kind of like the commit message in Git. All right, and now let's go back to our removal demo. Now we have a comment field here where you can specify, well, for example, a summary of the changes that you made to the content item. So that way, if somebody looks at the log, it's not just the changes that they see, but also the reason of the changes. So, for example, you could say something like, adding paragraph on hello, because this won't be removed anymore. And now this demo will be a hello demo instead. We won't remove it anymore. Permalink can remain because, well, you know, changing URLs for pages, that's usually not a good idea. Of course, you wouldn't include removal there. And let's add a paragraph here with just a hello. And let's publish. And now let's see what's in audit trail. Yeah, let me refresh. Here we have version 2. It's now called Hello Demo. Previously it was Removal Demo, so that's good. And you can see what changed here. So this is how you would use Audit Trail. It's a pretty useful feature to track everything that happens in the system. And again, while it has features built in, and likely these features will be extended on once this feature is actually released, you can also extend it. Pretty much everything in Orchard is extensible. Everywhere where there are multiple modules contributing on something, then there is nothing special in those modules. From your module, you can do the same. You can hook into Audit Trail as well, create your own events, or create your own Audit Trail log entries as well.